the family members just kept saying, how could this happen? How could they leave?
Tonight, we're learning more about the Halloween hit and run in Crestwood North. A woman and two children hit by a driver that left them for dead. Thankfully, some Good Samaritans were there to help.
WBTM 13's Gladys Bautista joins us live now from Birmingham Police Headquarters. Gladys, police are actively looking for the driver.
That's right, Guy Sherry. Police say that they are still looking for that dark colored Audi A3 that they believe may have been the car that hit that family. Now, this comes as residents in the Crestwood North community say that they are thinking of and praying for that 4-year-old little boy who remains in the hospital tonight with life-threatening injuries.
Terrifying moments on Halloween night in the Crestwood North neighborhood Tuesday, where resident Clark House says dozens of families were trick-or-treating.
There was traffic blocked both directions. And on top of that, about 400 people, 300 or 400 people, walking around through the traffic.
It was just before 8 p.m. when Birmingham police say a car investigators believe was traveling at a high rate of speed hit a 25-year-old woman, her 9-month-old baby, and a 4-year-old boy on 9th Avenue South near 56th Street South, right outside Nathan and Alexandra Scott's home.
My husband had said that he had heard a scream, and it wasn't like a fun kid, you know, Halloween scream. It was something that sounded awful.
Nathan Scott describes what he saw when he stepped outside.
Sister's holding the little boy in the middle of the street with the rest of the group hanging around just in hysterics.
And then when the ambulance tried to get through, they couldn't. And it was, we felt terrible. We tried to get people to move, and there's nothing anybody could do. The ambulance just had to keep hanging out and trying to get through until people moved down the street.
The woman and her infant are expected to be okay, while the 4-year-old boy remains in the hospital with life-threatening injuries.
Heartbreaking. No, nobody should have that happen to their child.
Now, these residents say they want to see change.
There needs to be a sidewalk. There needs to be a speed bump. There needs to be a stop sign on the corner of 56 and 9th. Any bit of that would have prevented this happening. You know, maybe more police presence of folks speeding around here.
And as this neighborhood comes together to help the family.
Neighbors trying to, you know, provide the family meals if needed, or just really being there for emotional support, because at the end of the day, it was pretty traumatic to experience.
Here's their message for the driver responsible.
If you have half a heart, half a mind, and some human decency, you need to turn yourself in. You know what you did.
Now, we did speak to residents in the neighborhood today who did not speak with us on camera, but they said that they did bring dinner to that family that remains in the hospital with that 4-year-old little boy. Now, the community says that all they're hoping for now is to get some traffic control in that area so that this never happens again. We'll have the Birmingham Police Headquarters for you tonight. Gladys Bautista, WBTM 13.